Welcome to My Secret Math Tutor. In this example, we are going to make a stem and leaf plot. Now, these are great plots. They give us an idea about the distribution of our data, but they can be a little tricky to make. The idea with making a stem and leaf plot is we are going to identify the leading values in all of these numbers, and that will become our stem. And then with the other values in the number, those will become the leaves. Alright, so let's see how this works out by first creating the stems. So I look at all the numbers in my leading values, and it looks like I have a 2, a 5, some 6s, 7s, and 8s. So it looks like my data goes between the 20s all the way up to 80s. So I'm going to use 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And these are my stems. I'm going to put a big vertical line to separate these out from the leaves. Here's where I start to collect all the other numbers. So if I have a 23, let's put the 3 there. When I get to this 3, well, I don't have any 30s, so I'm going to leave that one blank. No 40s, leave the 40 blank. Here's a 58, so let's go ahead and put an 8 next to that 5. And now we get into these 60s, and we got lots of 60s. In fact, I have two 62s, so I'm going to put a 2, and then I'm going to put another 2. So the way I read this is, here's one 62, and here's another 62. Let's keep going. So it looks like I also have a 63, a 65, and a 67. So 3, 5, and 7. All of these are my 60s. Alright, we're on a roll. So let's finish off these 70s. I got a 71, 71, and a 72. So 1, 1, and 2. And looks like I have some 80s. An 80, 82, 82, 82. Now, with the 80, make sure you go ahead and you put in a 0. You don't want to leave it blank, because the blank means that you don't have any of those particular data points. But we do have an 80, so put the 0. Then a couple of 82s. Oh, looks like another 82. 1, 2, 3 of them. So again, these numbers represent the leaves. So the way we read this is we recognize that this is our leading term, so 5, and there's our trailing term, so this would be a 58. You know, that number would be a 65. And we can see that many of our numbers are in, say, the 60s and 70s. So again, it gives us a great idea about the distribution of our numbers. And there you have it. If you'd like to see some more videos, please visit MySecretMathTutor.com.